That's right. All the news, 9 stories. This is where you get it. 9 top stories at 9. But the first big story, the land acquisition bill storm has taken over the budget session of the Lok Sabha. Soon it was tabled by the government. The Modi government is under fire for it, both inside and outside parliament. But the Prime Minister is firm on the changes he wants to bring in the crucial legislation. He asked his MPs to bust the myths alleged by the opposition. Interestingly, the farmers' cause has reunited Anna Hazare and his one-time protege. Smita Sharma and Maha Siddiqui have our top story tonight.
Mentor and protege are back together. Estranged comrades Anna and Kejriwal have set aside their differences. This time, their Lokpal is the controversial land acquisition bill.
अगर जिन किसानों पर अन्याय होता है, तो सब मिलकर उस अन्याय को दूर करने का कोशिश करें तो क्या बिगड़ गया?
ये संशोधन किसानों के खिलाफ है, ये संशोधन गरीबों के खिलाफ है, और हम इसका घोर विरोध करते हैं।
Of hullabaloo, crowds gathered, and Anna Hazare and his erstwhile Arjun or Arvind Kejriwal reunited yet again on the stage here in Jantar Mantar, protesting the government's move to amend the land acquisition bill, calling these amendments anti-poor, anti-farmer.
A vociferous TMC in an early morning protest.
Ratio as to how many bills have been passed and how many ordinances have been put in.
And inside the Rajya Sabha, a united opposition extracting a promise out of the government. But this came after a scathing attack from the opposition benches.
With no breakthrough in sight, the fate of the bill remains uncertain. For the time being, the government is contemplating putting the matter on the back burner for the first half of the budget session, only to take it up later, just before the ordinance lapses. With Smita Sharma, this is Maha Siddiqui in Delhi for Headlines Today.
Now, it's not the politicians and their voices only over the land bill that will matter in the weeks and months ahead. Our reporters have traveled to some of the areas where massive protests have taken place from farmers over land acquisition. Listen in to some voices from Ground Zero.
I am Kamlesh Sitar and I am in Bid district of Marathwada region in Maharashtra. We are going to talk to people about their views on the land acquisition bill. I have with me noted social activist Mr. Eknath Awad. Sir, what are your views?
Government is going to make the Land Acquisition Act, but this is the dangerous for farmer. But Land Acquisition Act is the dangerous for the life of farmers.
देखिए सर, पिछले 4 सालों से तो पहले सूखे से किसान मर रहे हैं. और अगर जिनके पास जो छोटी थोड़ी बहुत जमीन बची है वो भी अगर छिन जाएगी और उसका मुआवजा मांगने के लिए भी कहीं अधिकार नहीं रहेगा तो किसान तो पूरी तरह बर्बाद होना ही होना है.
I'm presently standing in Singur, the place and the land which had stood up against the machinery of the government and had fought for the land acquisition movement. आप बहुत लड़ाई किए थे इस आंदोलन में, लेकिन अब आपको लगता है कि ये जो अधिग्रहण अध्यादेश आ रहा है ये किसानों के खिलाफ है?
लेकिन ऐसा जो है कि जमीन अधिग्रहण करके आईन आ रहा है, ये हम लोग कभी मान नहीं सकते हैं. हम लोग सिंगूर का आदमी है. जब तक किसानों का कोई सुविधा नहीं मिलेंगे तो हम लोग कभी भी नहीं छोड़ेंगे, फिर भी आंदोलन करेंगे.
कोई किसान को इतना जानकारी नहीं है, किसी किसान को. किसान खेती करता है, बाल बच्चा को खिलाता है, लेकिन जो किसान जितना पैसा उसका मिलेगा वो पैसा उसके लिए कुछ नहीं है. कभी यहाँ का जमीन का जितना दाम है बहुत दाम है. क्यों? किसी का 10 लाख रुपया काटा है, कोई जगह में 2 लाख रुपया काटा है. और सरकार जो दाम देगा, चल सपोज 10,000 का 4 गुना देगा, 40,000 होगा. 40,000 भी जो देगा वो 2 साल बाद 40,000 के ऊपर हो जाएगा जमीन का दाम.
The story of the Indian farmer, why he feels alienated in his own land. We're in Bhatta Parsol, the village that saw the agitation that led to the 2013 Land Acquisition Act. सबसे बड़ी परेशानी जो इस ऑर्डिनेंस के जरिए सरकार कर रही है वो क्या दिखाई देती है? बड़ा डर.
देखिए, सबसे बड़ा डर है किसान की मर्जी के बिना.
हाँ.
और जो दूसरा डर है वो अब अदालत में भी किसान को जाने में परहेज हो।
सरकार बिल्कुल गलत कर रही है और इस किसान जो है इसमें पहले जो दो ये जो अध्यादेश आया था 2013 में इसमें कोर्ट में जाने का इसको अधिकार था, भूमि का मालिक था।
आपसे कितने लोगों के केस भी हैं इस वक्त पेंडिंग है केस?
So you can see the anger on the ground clearly. What is it about this land acquisition bill that is becoming so contentious? Before I come to my panel, I just want to give you a sense of why this issue is becoming such a hot potato. Take a look at what the UPA did and what the NDA did and why the land acquisition bill is going to become such a contentious issue. There are two clauses that really have become the real heart of the problem. The first is the issue of consent. How is consent going to be achieved? The fact is that consent is one critical clause. The UPA bill said that consent of 70% of the farmers was essential. The NDA government says it does not prior approval will no longer be required. In fact, 80% was required for private and public-private projects. The consent clause is the one big question mark. The second question mark is that over a social impact assessment. The UPA said this was a must for every acquisition. That has been now withdrawn in the NDA bill. That's the big question. Is this now really anti-farmer? That's the question we are going to raise. Joining me on my panel at the moment, Yogendra Yadav of the Aam Aadmi Party joins me. Vandana Shiva, activist, joins me. Also joining me is Medha Patkar, who's been taking a leading role in this entire agitation at the moment. She is with Anna Hazare in this entire movement. Also with me, Sunil Alagh. He'll give us an industrial perspective. He's seen as someone who's close to the ruling government. Gaurav Gogoi is of the Congress Party and Sudhanshu Mittal of the BJP. But I just want to understand this. What is it about this present law that is angering so many of you? Medha Patkar, since you're there right in the heart of this agitation, you take that first. Is this simply part of a larger ideological struggle that you're waging? Because the fact is that developers are claiming in this country that if the land acquisition bill doesn't go through, development infrastructure projects will get stalled and this country needs speedy infrastructure projects. You, on the other hand, seem to believe that this is only part of some corporate conspiracy. So are you fighting an ideological war here?
There is a difference of ideology, no doubt, because that ultimately bottles down and reflects into the development paradigm. Mm-hmm. And all these decades, the development paradigm, which was based on the British legacy, was on the basis of the principle of eminent domain of the state. So the state can do whatever it wants to in the name of development. And today the state is privatized and corporatized. And then the people's eminent domain, the people's participation, role and primacy in the development planning was negated, ignored and rejected. But in this 2013 Act, due to number of people's movements all over the country, I must say that the UPA had to take up the matter, and the parliamentary committees under the chairmanship of BJP's own leaders Kalyan Singh and Sumitra Mahajan, but with the approval of all party MPs, really brought in that act. So in that act, when this consent and the social impact assessment came up, it was clear that the participation of the affected farmers at least would start. But now that also is being kept out due to this ordinance, which is going back to the British legacy. Hence, in the name of development, in which the corporatization and privatization is now making a huge change, the industrial corridors like projects where lakhs of hectares of land is going to be grabbed, or even the housing for the poor, where much of the land in the hands of the poor is diverted to the builders. All of that now
ma'am,
will
you're
go
not answering
ahead
my question
without
and I need to put
any democratic process.
Ma'am, you're not answering my
so
question.
Any democratic
how do you respond to the fact that developers in this country are saying that if the land acquisition bill involves 80% consent of farmers in each instance, if it involves a social impact assessment done by an expert committee, these projects will never take off? And they therefore believe that what you are saying is anti-development as they see it. So it's your vision of development versus the way someone else might see it.
You see, even when the developers take a decision, about a project, they are free to opt for it or against it. So isn't there a risk when they would reject the project and they would also leave it halfway and they would get all the facilities from the government but will not start the project? That is already happening. So why not the choice and the primacy be given to the farmers as well? That is the injustice which has been helping the so-called developers to push the projects in the name of development.
Can I?
The farmers will not oppose a project if there is a social impact which will be taken care of, minimizing and also compensating.
Okay,
but they are afraid that even that much concession and space and justice should not be done. So
I'm asking my producers to flash what you're saying, because I think we need to focus on that, really, on this issue. So, you know, you are claiming that farmers will not object if the social assessment impact clause takes place. But the question is, how long will this take? And that is where the problem... That's where the problems are starting. Yogendra Yadav, I come back to it. Figures that are being suggested, many Congress chief ministers themselves have objected to this issue. Many industrialists are objecting to it. They are saying this will lead to the de-industrialization of the country. That if you do not allow this Land Acquisition Act to go, India will get de-industrialized. This is the strongest argument which is being made at the moment.
Rajdeep, we have this big debate taking place in the country, and I don't know if most of the viewers actually understand what is it that is being debated. What actually happened was that after 120 years, a colonial law was changed a year ago. This was not a Congress law. BJP was party to it. The entire parliament agreed to it. And after 120 years, it was said that, all right, for acquisition, we'll do at least two or three civil things. We'll get farmers' consent, at least 70% of them. That will do assessment of who else might be affected, and we'll see whether it affects agriculture in that area very deeply. Nothing great, just elementary civility that any government should extend to its farmers. And what is happening is that within a year, without that act really having come into force, the basic spirit of that act has been changed, that too through a back door, through an ordinance. The heart of the ordinance is the provision that all these three things, consent, social impact assessment and multi-crop assessment, will not be done in five exceptional cases. Now you might say, all right, only five exceptions. But these five exceptions are such, Rajdeep, that they have the entire universe in that five exceptions.
It could include public-private partnerships, it could include infrastructure, rural infrastructure projects, it includes defense projects, it includes industrial corridors. You are saying that these exceptions are such that these exceptions will prevent any clause, any project coming up which need not have the consent of farmers. You're basically saying the exceptions will be the rule.
Exactly. I cannot imagine any acquisition that will not fall under these five categories. So basically what the government has done is that in the name of an amendment, they have annulled the original act altogether. Let me clarify that there were some procedural issues. And if industry had some serious issues, probably some light, small tweaking of the procedures may have been reasonable. But in the name, you know, and the opportunity, the government seemed to have just given in to industrial lobbies or corporate lobbies, not even industrialists, because CII had actually taken a very sensible position on this.
No, I want the government side and the industry side at the end, because I want to hear all the opponents. Let's hear them once and find out what is your specific opposition. Vandana Shiva, what is your specific opposition? Is it, as I told Medha Patkar, an ideological opposition? Is this because your vision of what constitutes development in India is very different from what a CII vision of development would be in India?
There are three big reasons why I think this land grab ordinance, and that's what it should be called, is dangerous for India. And this is not about what politics you believe in, it's just knowing how social, political, economic processes
Give me a
work. First of all,
let's talk of specifics.
This issue of The Economist talks about India flying.
Yes.
And the first thing they say is land ordinance should be pushed through. Now, any global interest who say India's democracy should be destroyed for our interests, something's wrong there.
Hold on. The Economist...
Let me finish my argument, Rajdeep.
You can't use The Economist now to make an argument...
I'm saying is that not only are they bypassing the parliament, they are bypassing the entire country. Now, for me, the issue of social impact assessment is vital, because we've seen what pushing people off the land has done. The tribal areas were the most peaceful areas in this country. Look where they are, as the PESA was violated, as the constitutional rights of tribals were violated. Even Syria, where everyone is hyper. Syria's problems began with displacement of 800,000 farmers. And we need to realize what happens when large numbers of farmers get uprooted. Okay, one of the issues that you haven't raised, which is vital also to people who are not losing their land, is the fact that the amendment that has been annulled had a major food security impact. Now, unlike the West, which grows crops in one season, we have lands that are fertile, and most of the lands around cities are these three crop and four crop land. Our calculations of productivity have been wrong. I spent my last 30 years doing this. We could be feeding 2 to 3 Indias. But if India uproots her small farmers, there is no country in the world that could grow the kind of food 1.2 billion people need.
Your specific concern is about multi-crop fertile land being
about
also
food security.
Because you believe industry will focus on multi-crop fertile land, which is close.
Because that's where the city are. That's okay. Where the cities are.
Can I bring in Gaurav Gogoi? I want to get, as I said, all the opponents first. And Gaurav Gogoi, it's interesting because the Congress party, in
I think you should call us the defenders of the livelihoods of the Indian people and democracy in India, not opponents to a narrow vested interest wanting to grab the land of the people who hold this country's food security.
Let me bring in every
you're totally evading the issue of food security, and that's at the heart of farmland.
You've raised the issue of food security. Yogendra Yadav is saying the exceptions will dilute the very rule and the very purpose of the Act. Medha Patkar is also concerned about what it does for farmers in terms of their rights. Gaurav Gogoi, the Congress party is more interesting because your chief ministers like Prithviraj Chavan had in a sense opposed even aspects of the original land acquisition bill that your government brought in. They were also worried about the impact that it would have on a process of gradual deindustrialization. That was their concern, that infrastructure projects would never take off if you ask for 80% consent, for example, of farmers. They also wanted the act diluted. Is the Congress and other parties just playing politics?
Rajdeep, the 2013 UPA Act was done in consultation with all political parties, all groups, and the kind of protest that we are seeing today, we did not see them in 2013 when the Act was passed. We are seeing them in 2014-15 after the BJP has brought its ordinance. So by and large, we have to understand the difference in public reaction towards this land acquisition issue and how the various ruling parties are handling this. UPA consulted with everyone, had democratic consultations, we had standing committees evaluating, we took in some of their suggestions, they were part of the Land Acquisition Act. But on contrast, the BJP has been totally opaque and ambiguous in the way it's handling this.
So
it is unable to explain why it passed
your concern is the procedure
Act in the first place.
Your
if they
concern
were going to
seems
amend
to be the
it
procedure
and bring in a new acquisition. Secondly, the route. My concern is the arrogant way in which the BJP is bringing in this legislation, which is anti-farmer without any form of democratic consultation, and which is evidently pandering to the interest of big corporate lobbies only.
You know,
why is there been so many changes and dilutions in the definition of a private company, and it has been now expanded to mean a private entity, and all the clauses that protected the farmer? Remember, the basic principles of the 2013 Act was consent and fair compensation. They have removed the consent without having the social impact assessment. You cannot give fair compensation to the original land owner.
Can I?
Surely, it is the duty of the government to protect the interests of the farmers and the landowners who are protesting on the streets of Delhi and across the country.
Okay, let me then. We've heard four different views, in a sense, of those who are opponents of what the government has done. Sudhanshu Mittal, let's turn to you. Let's turn to you and ask whether the government, in a sense, could have done this with better procedures, taken a broader consensus. And the fact is that there are elements now within the Sangh Parivar, your own farmer unions, who are protesting. There is a genuine concern that the farmer is losing out here. And we are, at the end of the day, whether you like it or not, a nation of kisans.
Rajdeep, let us discuss the merit of the proposition first, and then we'll discuss the politics of the proposition. Because these two things are not in consonance with each other right now. Mm-hmm. I will refer to the first story which you showed. You took us to Marathwada, you took us to Singur, and you took us to Bhattaparsol. In all the three, huh?
Yes.
In all the three cases, what was the underlining grievance? The underlining grievance was muawza. Ki saab muawza nahi milta. Muawza ye hai, muawza wo hai. You know, we have to get out of the mindset of the old act, where there was a cheating of the farmer when a land worth a lakh rupees was then taken over by the government at say 20,000 rupees. The real value was only 20% of the value of the land, which was given as compensation. So naturally, if such an unfair proposition is raw deal is given to the farmers, there was a protest. And that is the entire mindset with which we are viewing this. You know, today getting a compensation four times the market price when it is a rural land, or two times the market price when it is an urban land, and not only is there a job guaranteed with this, 20% of the developed land can be taken back by the farmer on a certain principle of payment. Now this is the underlying spirit of this act. Mm-hmm. Which must be studied in terms of what the farmers are now today saying.
Okay, you make
the an farmers are happy.
Yeah, can I just hold you for a moment? Can I just hold you? You make an important point about compensation. Let's just settle this. Yogendra Yadav, you know, before I come to Sunil Alag, respond to what Sudhanshu Mittal is saying. Let's be clear. The farmer today wants compensation. He wants jobs. People are moving away from the farm sector, coming to urban areas. India is, whether you like it or not, more and more people are moving away from rural areas, looking at urban areas. You therefore need to create jobs. And you need to provide them adequate compensation. Sudhanshu Mittal says, if I provide 4x compensation to a rural land and 2x to an urban land, what's the problem?
Rajdeep, compensation is an issue. It's not the only issue. Land acquisition, and remember, we are not discussing purchase pacts. This is compulsory, forcible acquisition of someone's property.
I'm giving you 4x compensation for it.
Rajdeep, if I buy your house, tomorrow I tell you I'm taking away your suit, and I tell you I'm giving you this compensation. Minimally, I need to be able to told, do I wish to give it away? But anyway, forget it. Compensation is an issue, and I understand that in the short run, immediately, farmers are agitated about compensation. That hits them immediately. It hits them very hard. But BJP is actually indulging in subterfuge on this as well. I have in my hand an notification by Haryana government. This is about compensation, Mr. Sudhanshu Mittal. They say that every farmer will get four times more than the price determined through registry or the collectorate rate, etc. Haryana government in one stroke has reduced it by half. This is a notification of Haryana government, 4th December. This is Mr. Khattar's government, BJP government. And what they have done is that the original act said that the price of the land is to be multiplied by a factor of 2 plus solatium, which is equivalent to the same amount. So basically what it meant was that if your rate is 20 lakhs, you get 20 into 2, 40 plus 40 solatium, so you get 80. This is what everyone believed and thought was going to be given to them. Haryana government has now reduced it in rural areas throughout Haryana to 1, which is to say you will get 20 into 1 plus 20. You'll get only 40 lakhs. So the central government kicks the farmer from the left hand, and the state government takes away the remaining from the right hand. This is what is happening. And this is only continuation of a series of cheating that's happening.
Sudhanshu, before, do you want to respond to that? That this entire issue of compensation, it has been raised in the past. Yeah. And this is where when governments come in, particularly when governments come in and deal with the farmers, there's a sense that the farmer is getting shortchanged.
Rajdeep, what are we discussing? I'm amazed. You know, every time a discussion takes place, things which are foreign to the core issue are always introduced to mislead people.
No, how is it foreign?
We are discussing about a central...
How is it foreign?
Allow me, Nara.
How is compensation foreign?
Allow me to make the statement. Rajdeep, I have not said that. You have not had the patience to hear me. See, it's an unfair panel because you have two AAP candidates who fought the Lok Sabha. I'm the only poor guy who is to defend, and you don't want to give me time. Now give me time so that a lot of misnomers which are being spread by all these people need to get clarified.
Yes.
First thing, we are discussing a central legislation. The central legislation is very, very clear on the compensation which has to be given, which is four times. I have traveled across the country, also talked to the farmers. I said, tell me, tumhari land 1 lakh rupee ki hai, तुम्हें अगर इसकी जगह 4 लाख बोले हुजूर भाई बाप इसको करवा दो, हमारी लैंड ले लो दिलवा दो, यू नो योर अजम्पशन इज द फार्मर इज रेजिस्टेंट टू इट. माई फील इन द ग्राउंड इज द फार्मर विल मोस्ट ही बी मोस्ट हैप्पी ट्रेडिंग ऑफ हिज लैंड फॉर 4 times द प्राइस बिकॉज आफ्टर प्राइस वॉट ही डू इज बाय थ्राइस द लैंड ही हैड एंड वन पोर्शन विच इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द लैंड ही हैड ही विल स्पेंड इट ऑन हिज लाइवलीहुड एंड बी हैप्पी देयर आफ्टर. Okay. This is a mindset. So, you know, secondly, what the state governments do if it is ultra vires a constitution, it cannot be held valid. It will not be held valid. A central legislation is superior to a state legislation when it is a concurrent list. So let's not debate what Haryana is doing. We are debating what central government is doing.
More importantly,
Rajdeep, here the issue is what? Mm-hmm. The issue is, it is only specified to 5 exceptions. Only 5 exceptions. Now, Mr. Yogendra,
sir, majority of infrastructure projects will be covered by those. With majority of projects will be covered by those exceptions. I can tell you, even your ally Shiv Sena is now objecting to it. Even your ally Shiv Sena. So it's not matter. It's not just Aam Aadmi Party. It's not just Anna Hazare.
Rajdeep, we are not discussing the politics of it. We are discussing the merit of it.
Yes,
allow me to give one more merit about it.
Yes.
One more merit.
Yes.
Take private housing. Mm-hmm. Today, a lot of land has been acquired in Gurgaon and all the other places for private housing. Is it covered under this? No, it is not covered. A lot of land has been taken for individual industries, mm-hmm. big industries. Is this covered under this? No, it is not covered under this. All things which relate to the so-called crony capitalism, are they covered under these exceptions? No. What is covered? National security, defense, rural electrification. You know what is happening is, the real act and the purpose of the real act is deliberately being subsided by an impression that it is all pervasive. No, it is not all pervasive.
Can I?
And lastly, as I said, farmer is resistant.
Can I hold
He's
you?
Not. A farmer is happy with this.
Okay, farmer is happy. Can I for a moment before Sunil Alang, I'm sorry to bring in so late, but I want you to hold on to one more thought that Sudhanshu has raised. I want Medha Patkar to respond. Medha Patkar, here is Sudhanshu Mittal saying that farmers are happy. Farmers would be happy if they got adequate compensation. They are ready to make this move from rural to a more semi-urban lifestyle, provided you provided them adequate compensation. Is what his basic argument is.
I don't know on what basis is he talking about it. First of all, he should know that he is responding not just to the other political parties, but to the strong people's movements, which have raised the voice in the nook and corner of the country, and that is why we are on this panel. The second thing is,
we all know the
resettlement and rehabilitation part, they have not touched because that is already weak in the 2013 Act. When it talks about the twice to four times the market value itself is defined on the basis of the Tahsildars, the state's guideline, and not the real market value. And as far as the twice or four times the luring kind of offer is concerned, that also is not really followed through the state bills. As Yogendra Yadavji has put it, I'll give you another example of Madhya Pradesh, where Shivraj Singh Chauhan has straight away started with twice the market value, which also is not coming through. And anyway, twice or four times the market value will not help the person to buy alternative land. That is, will not give him rehabilitation. And that is British legacy. So people are not happy, and if they are happy today, they will be unhappy and weeping.
Can I just for a moment press the pause button and then come to you, Sunil Alag, because what is it that industry is concerned about? Is industry concerned, as some of them say, that this act will prevent any major projects from emerging? Is that the fear, that as a result of having to take the consent of 80% farmers?
See, look, at this point of time, the industry is being made out to be the bad guys. Mm-hmm. I'm not for one minute here to defend industry. Mm-hmm. The whole thing that was passed earlier for 1 year hasn't worked, okay? So industry went back to BJP and said, look, this is what we think are the problems. BJP has listened to it, has come up with some amendments. Why have they introduced an ordinance? Is because the last time Rajya Sabha only discussed Ghar Wapsi and X and forgot about the nation and never allowed any discussion to take place on the real problems of India.
Yes.
That forced the BJP to come up with an ordinance. Now there is miscommunication on a large scale. On a large scale, I saw on your program, nobody is explaining to the farmers that, look, you have the right to say no except in the following areas. Do you agree with that? They are being told your rights are being taken away. Of course, everyone is going to oppose it. BJP has failed to communicate, if you ask me, what they are doing. Now, if Yogendra Yadav, whom I respect a lot, feels that in three areas it's okay, I agree with defense, I agree with X, but I don't agree with one or two. If BJP doesn't agree with those two suggestions, then you bring about an andolan. You are bringing about an andolan in advance without discussing it in parliament, without bringing up the issues. You bring in Anna Hazare, who's now become a political figure compared to the Jan Lokpal bill when he was a social issue. Now, where is the nation going? I am not saying industry is right. Industry said 5 years is not enough to go through with a project. BJP, okay, opened it up. Today you can say, all right, let's bring it to 8 years. Don't give it for 5 years. If you don't complete your project in 8 years, whatever is the new land value at that time, if you paid 100 rupees in the beginning, it becomes 120 then. You pay 20 rupees extra to the farmer. There's a solution to everything. If everyone goes into black and white, this nation is never going to progress. It's about time everybody came out with their specific problems to deal with it. What a state does. Why is it doing two times? You're discussing a process now. There's nothing wrong with the law. Somebody is flouting the law. So change it. If you think you're not interested in the way the market price is determined, 1 second, I've heard everybody, please let me finish.
Yes.
You put in a committee, say Medha Patkar will sit in the committee to say what is the market price. On that, please give 4 times. We want concrete suggestions. We don't want a resistance to everything that is happening in this nation. That is what is happening. I will oppose everything. I will accept nothing. Now it's about time in parliament. Again, you'll have a walkout. Where in parliament I never heard one party today even raise one specific issue which they wanted changed. Now you're putting BJP into a corner. They'll get into an ego problem. They'll dig their heels.
Hold on.
Let's come to the specific. I am today spending
extra time on this because it is a complex issue. It is not a black and white issue. I accept that. The question is, how do you find solution?
I'm not saying that industry is right.
No, I'm not saying BJP is right. Let me come to the specific suggestions which you want changed. Don't say I will oppose the bill. Just a minute. We'll come to specific suggestions.
They did not come out with any specific suggestions.
No, I'm coming out with a specific suggestion.
So it is a post facto consultation.
No, that's another matter.
Can I also say something?
Madam Medha Patkar, please, I'm talking about Parliament.
Yes.
I'm talking about Parliament. Either you are in Parliament or out of Parliament.
Ma'am, can we do this one by one?
If all the parliamentarians have already given consent to this 2013 Act, I will ask my producers to lower the mic.
I want
protesting without understanding.
For once, let's have a debate without noise. Let's have a debate without noise. There are valid issues that Sunil Alag raises, which are, this is not a black and white issue. The farmer's son also needs jobs. India is adding 10 lakh jobs a month. He needs jobs. He needs projects to come up. Infrastructure projects need to come up. They are part of the growth process. It's not about economists, you know, having one agenda versus Vandana Shiva having another agenda. I am saying, what is the middle ground? Is there a middle ground that can be done if the process is made more transparent about compensation, for example? Would that satisfy the agitators? Or is this simply in the belief that this entire land acquisition ordinance, in the way it has been framed, is anti-farmer? Yogendra first and then you, Vandana.
Rajdeep, the Act of 2013 itself was a middle ground.
Yes.
It was not an extreme kind of an act. It came after 2 years of parliamentary haggling. Social activists like Medha Patkar did not agree with that act even then.
Yes.
It was indeed a middle ground. Now it's that middle ground which is already being shifted to a non-existent point.
Sunil Alag is making the point. Why don't you decide? Why don't activists say these are four or five areas? where we believe that very clearly you need to change the process by which land is handed over. Other areas, if private developers, for example, directly communicate with the farmer, sure, strike a deal directly with the farmer, so be it.
Rajdeep, it's actually the other way around. The country's entire political establishment reached a middle ground. Now it is for industry, now it is for public sector, now it is for every other user to point out specifically these are the real difficulties that we have faced. Sunil Alag says it hasn't worked. I'm stunned. An act that was never implemented has never worked. We now know that it hasn't worked. Give it a chance. Find out what the problems are, and I'm sure it has problems. Let's correct it. So the onus should now be, the country's political establishment had worked out a middle ground. The onus should be now on the industry. And I personally, for one, would be willing to consider if there are procedural hassles, if there are unavoidable delays, these should probably be addressed. Smart ways can be found out. But now to say, I have abrogated that act, now you tell me what do you want, this is weird. And let me also say, since Sunil Alagji has said that he respects me, let me just ask him. He's serious. He was not saying that in jest or anything. But, let's say, are we looking at exemptions?
No, I wasn't saying it in jest, Yogendra.
No, of course, I agree. I agree with that. That's why I'm saying this. Let's agree once and for all. Are we dealing with five small exceptions, or are we dealing with the entire rule being abrogated? I'm suggesting,
as a result of these exceptions, you believe the rule is being abrogated.
These five exemptions, Sunil ji, would cover 95% of all the acquisitions that are covered. 95% things will be covered under this. This is not an exemption.
Can I discuss it? What you don't want. No, Yogendra, what you don't want, let's discuss. If BJP doesn't listen, then have an andolan. How can you have an andolan in advance? That's all I'm saying. Tell BJP what your objections are in parliament. If they don't listen, then you have an andolan. You're having an andolan in advance. You are not going to listen, so let's have an andolan. That's all I'm saying. I'm not saying BJP is right. Have a discussion, have a debate.
This is not fair. The government brings out an ordinance in the middle of two sessions.
Can I for a moment? Yogendra, one second. One second, Yogendra. In another channel, Mr. Khaitan said no farmer will object to you taking away his land for hospitals and for defense and for everything else. If no farmer is going to object, why are you objecting to it? So you should just say, I have no objection to the following areas, but the others I do. So if you want no farmer approval in the following areas, I agree with it. Your Mr. Khaitan said it today.
Can I, for a moment, hold on, Sunil, I need to take a break. But I, before that, Vandana Shiva, suppose I want to set up a multi-speciality hospital and it's a public-private partnership. Surely this country needs more of that. Surely a procedure can be evolved which is speedy, which is transparent, and which is fair. Well, I'm looking at three concepts. It has to be speedy, it has to be transparent, it has to be fair to the landholder. I agree with Yogendra's point. If my house is to be sold, I must have the right to decide whether I want to sell it, but at what price I want to sell it, but make the process as fair as possible.
The first thing is, hospitals are being constantly set up with direct interaction of hospital setters with the farmers. The state doesn't come in to forcefully appropriate the land. Second, Mr. Alag is behaving as if land grab is happening today, and he's saying, don't protest before. 20 years of this country's history has only been a history of protests against land grab. Whether you take Chhattisgarh or Jharkhand or Singur or Bhattapersol or Dadri. And when I'm talking about his jobs, talking about jobs,
I cannot argue with you about the past.
You know, the former Prime Minister, Dr. VP Singh, was chair of the movement on land sovereignty. We were together at Dadri, and then we created a group. We did an assessment. If the numbers of farmers who are being planned to be uprooted, given the kinds of projects of industrial corridors, etc., how long would it take on current levels of job generation in industry and urban areas for all of the displaced to get absorbed? You know, the figure of a committee under the former Prime Minister VP Singh was 385 years. So this dangling of jobs is an issue where we have to recognize that farmers' livelihood just cannot be replaced either on the food security front or the numbers front.
The big question that we are asking is the present government's land ordinance that is threatening to stall parliament anti-farmer. What is the solution? It is the critical issue for this country's future. Let me get solutions, therefore, from all our panelists at the end of this long debate tonight. Gaurav Gogoi, a solution first. Is the Congress party willing to meet the BJP halfway? Are you willing to reach out and say, look, we recognize that there are certain concerns that have been raised by developers, by industry. We are ready to also reconcile those. Are you ready for that?
Rajdeep, my sincere advice to the BJP is that it's losing its credibility with its constant flip-flops and U-turns. They should return to the 2013 Act. It had conditions for consent, compensation, rehabilitation and due procedures. Let them, if there are problems in the implementation of it, let us have wider set of consultations and let them follow the UPA method of having democratic.
No, so you're saying basically stick to the 2013 Act, don't dilute it.
It needs to be amended.
Okay, you're saying there can be no amendments. You're saying don't dilute it. My question.
Absolutely, Rajdeep. It has not even been implied. Rajdeep, they are barren lands which they have not used for industrial purposes. They are lands under the SEZ banks which they can use. They are barren lands and wastelands and SEZ lands which can be utilized, why are they targeting the fertile lands of a farmer?
Can I ask all my panelists to restrict?
As anti-development, the Gaurav, farmer of India is pro-development.
Gaurav, let's not make political statement now. We just want 30 seconds each. Sudhanshu Mittal, your government had supported this very act. Your party had supported it when you were in the opposition. Now you're in government. You seem to have done a U-turn. Are you ready to reach out, as Arun Jaitley suggested today in Parliament, more than halfway to resolve this issue? Because industry needs land and the farmers need compensation and the farmers need their rights protected.
Rajdeep, where is the question of a U-turn? We have supported the Act. We have just amended a few provisions for the exceptions which have to be incorporated. That's about it. See, the only difference is we never played politics on issues of development. You have a solution if people stop playing politics on this. Because what was earlier a part of their philosophy has suddenly turned anti-farmer. So be it.
It is precisely these amendments. Hold on. You've had your... I'm giving everyone 30 seconds.
I've not even had 10 seconds.
Yes.
Let's be fair, Rajdeep.
Yes.
I mean, you're not being fair. Let's be fair. Look, the Act says four times the compensation. It does not outline how the compensation of the market value has to be calculated. If there are problems in calculating the market value, let's suggest a transparent way. Where is the problem?
Okay.
You see, the Act has the provisions.
You made a point, sir. Sir, I have to stop you because I am running out of time. Medha Patkar, you know, the feeling is that you are determined to block any move that the government makes. That this particular government, the BJP-led government in particular, is seen as an ideological opponent. So for you, partly this is an ideological battle.
Did we block or did we get the 2013 Act through the protests? Let the opponents address this. The second thing is that the Act itself is the minimum 2013 Act and not maximum. It is reasonable, not unreasonable. Much remains to be done for the government projects. The consent is necessary also for the government projects. In resettlement rehabilitation, livelihood-based rehabilitation is a must. Cash compensation, as in Sardar Sarovar, leads to only fake registries and huge corruption, which is generally ignored. And the people actually don't get rehabilitated.
Okay.
So we need further discussion on the 2013 Act. The ordinance must be repealed, and that is brought in through undemocratic procedure.
Okay,
you've had your say, ma'am. To be discussed also.
She is making a wrong statement. She is making a wrong statement, and we are allowing her to do that because it does not relate to the new Act. Sardar Sarovar was guided by the old Land Acquisition Act and not this.
I unfortunately have run out of time as a result of this.
No, but in the guard, what is the wrong statement?
I'm telling you,
because this is not the new Act.
Okay,
Sardar Sarovar was not guided by the new Act.
I am afraid.
Hold on. Let me switch off the mic.
he will switch off the mic. I am giving 10 seconds to you, Sunil Alag, and 10 to Yogendra. First to you, Sunil Alag, 10 seconds, the one thing that you'd like to see from an industry perspective to resolve this. 10 seconds, don't go beyond.
Look, I would look for a healthy debate in Parliament. Let them raise all the issues. And if BJP does not listen and doesn't meet it, then you start an Andolan. Don't start an Andolan before.
Okay, that's my only point. Okay, you're saying forget the Andolan, focus on a debate in Parliament. Yogendra, 10 seconds. Yogendra, run out of time. Yogendra, 10 seconds.
Instead of resolving it in the Parliament, my suggestion is that the Prime Minister of India should undertake a yatra and go to at least 10 places where acquisition has actually taken place. I'm sure the Prime Minister will agree with me. And if he doesn't have time, he's a very busy man, Rajdeep. You should do 10 programs. Go to places where acquisition has taken place.
I wouldn't mind doing
come
that.
Back,
and you're saying the Prime Minister...
Come back, Rajdeep, you and I will agree.
You're saying next time the Prime Minister's Man Ki Baat could be after he's done a yatra where he's met farmers. That's what you would like. He's been addressing various constituencies. It's time perhaps to communicate to the farmers. I've run out of time. I'm sorry, Vandana.
All I wanted to say is the Home Minister said he will consult with farmers. They should bring back the consultation clause and they should do an overall food security assessment.
You've made the point.
No, I'm saying if every fourth Indian is hungry and every second child is stunted and wasted, let the government
Again, we are mixing issues. At the end of the day,
but food security was part of the 2013 amendment.
Okay, you believe food security is very much part of the 2013 amendment?
Of course it is.
Okay, so effectively, time is running out. The thing is that we need this within a fixed time frame. And I think that is important.
And the government will be being irresponsible if it totally damages
the security. Ma'am, I have run out of time. Thank you all to all my guests. I'm afraid we've run completely out of time. We focused on this issue because we believe this is critical to the future of this country. And it needs to be debated inside and outside Parliament. My take at the end of the program. It is a pity in a sense that the battle over land legislation is now caught in a political and ideological tangle. The farmer needs protection and compensation. The developer needs speedy clearances. We need to create a win-win for both. Only a legal architecture that respects the rights of the landholder can really achieve that. And we hope that's what any future law will do. Respect the landholder, the farmer. Good night, goodbye.